Every time I babysit, I wonder what the baby is thinking. And when it cries, I'm like, what? What, small human? What are you trying to tell me? The meaning of life? And stop calling me peasant. Hey guys, Julia here for DNews. Babies, man, babies. Cute, cooing, pooping little humans. Well, adorable, they aren't the smartest in the bunch. I mean, I hide behind my hands and they think I'm gone forever, and peekaboo, my face just pops out of nowhere. Haha, object impermanence. But lately, researchers are finding out babies are smarter than we think. A recent study published in the journal Developmental Science found that babies can reason logically even before the age of one, which apparently researchers thought people couldn't do until the age of 5 or 6. How do researchers figure this out, you ask? Well, it's not like they could just give babies a logic problem to solve. Instead, they had them watch puppets. In this study, the puppets acted out a little scene of social hierarchy. Basically, puppet 1 is more dominant than puppet 2. Then in another scene, puppet 2 is more dominant than puppet 3. So who would be more dominant? Puppet 1 or puppet 3? If you said puppet 1, congratulations, you're just as smart as a 10-month-old baby. You can understand transitive inference, which is the type of deductive reasoning that allows someone to make inferences about things that weren't explicitly compared before. Basically, the researchers could tell what a baby understood based on how long they stared at the puppet show. If the show went against the transitive inference and puppet 3 was more dominant, then the babies were confused and stared longer. That's based on earlier research that shows when something is unfamiliar or unexpected, babies will look at it longer. And it seems it's not the only thing young infants can grasp. Knowledge of social situations seems to get wired in pretty early on in brain development. In a study published in the Journal of Experimental Psychology, researchers found that infants as young as 9 months could understand that people were likely to be friends based on their shared interests. For example, if they had the same reactions to food. In this study, researchers showed babies videos where people ate food. They either really liked it or made a kind of gesture about it. The babies expected those who liked the same food to be friends and were confused when they weren't friends. The researchers take this to mean that babies are very aware of what's going on around them and keep track of people's interactions. Babies even have a kind of theory of mind around 18 months old, according to a study published in Developmental Psychology, which researchers thought kids couldn't do until 8 or so. Theory of mind is trying to imagine what's going on in someone else's head, that someone else may want something different from what you want. In one clever experiment, a researcher gave babies 2 bowls. One was filled with broccoli and the other filled with tasty fish crackers. The babies preferred the crackers. Then the researcher would eat from one of the bowls and either make a happy or disgusted reaction. They gave the bowls back to the baby and asked, "Can I have some?" If the researcher acted happy about the baby gave them broccoli, even though that's not what the babies preferred. This showed that young children could understand someone else's desires and use that information in how they responded to them. Heck, even adults struggle with this sometimes. So babies are capable of logical reasoning and a kind of empathy, something researchers thought wasn't possible before. So one of the lead researchers of the broccoli goldfish study, Dr. Allison Gopnik, believes adults can learn a thing or two from babies. You know how I said babies stare at things that are new or confusing? Well, babies are really good at paying attention to lots of new and novel things. They just kind of soak in everything. Well, as we grow up, we learn to focus on just one thing, and sometimes that can blind us to other possibilities. She said in an op-ed in the Wall Street Journal that babies, on the other hand, seem to have a positive hunger for the unexpected. And that means they're like little ideal scientists. Yeah, now I'm kind of terrified to babysit again. I might not be so terrified of babies if I knew exactly what I was getting into. I mean, what if you could control every detail about your baby? Sounds like science fiction? Well, designer babies might not be too far off in the future. To learn more about that, check out this video where Julian and I debate the pros and cons of designing your baby. So why are scientists getting so freaked out about it? Well, there's a fear of designer babies. For example, Julian could change the length of a kid's finger or make sure they have his same beautiful blue eyes.
Yep, and a tail.
All right, guys, have you had any experience with crazy smart babies? Tell us about it down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back to DNews so you don't miss a single episode.